वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. तो टुडेस डिस्कशन वी हैव टू डू अबाउट द शिफ्ट रजिस्टर. तो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द शिफ्ट रजिस्टर प्लीज रिकॉल द बिफोर क्लास. इन बिफोर क्लास ऑलरेडी वी हैव फिनिश्ड द डिस्कशन ओवर द डिफरेंट सिक्वेंशियल सर्किट्स. लाइक जस्ट बिफोर क्लास इज ओवर द फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स, दैट इज वन सिक्वेंशियल सर्किट. Like that, flip-flop is also one type of sequential circuit. Shift register is also one type of sequential circuits. So today's discussion is about another type of sequential circuit, logic circuit, that is named as the shift register. So please recall again the before class, why we call sequential circuit word here. In before class also the sequential word, in this class also sequential word. Because all the digital circuits basically classified into broadly two classes. We know one special class was over that. What is the difference between sequential circuit and combinational circuit? So very briefly finish this part. Overall, the digital circuits are classified into two categories. One is combinational and another is sequential. Under the combinational, already we have finished so many logic devices like adder, subtractor, multiplexer, demultiplexer, like that. Similarly, under the sequential circuit also we have finished the flip-flops, and also another example is counter, and this is also one example which is today's topic, that is shift register. Then let us start about the shift register. Now we don't have any doubt what is sequential circuit, and under that this is also one device, logic device. So before going through the detail point, first of all we have to first focus, what is the main purpose of today's class? Today's class is not completely the all over or each and every data over the register. Today's class aim is only how we easily understand what is shift register and how many types of shift register and where we get the shift register, why we are choosing the shift register, like that. Then the basic classes of register. First of all, if you well known about this matters, then we can proceed to different higher order and practical applicability, and what is the extra extension of these registers, how we use these register ICs for any other applications, that is in next class. So let us start. As for the today's class, our basic outlines are like this: shift register, what, where and why. So first of all, what is shift register? Please see the outlines. First of all, we cover about briefly the what, where and why shift register. Then we finish different classifications. Then how we implement the basic classes of shift register. Then the final applications. So we can be very well known about the applications from this part partly. So let us start. What is shift register? Shift register is one type of sequential circuit basically used for memory device or for storing the digital data. That is the very basic meaning. And basically it operates in synchronous with a clock pulse. Without clock pulse you never, it is not okay to operate the register. That means as per the clock pulse we can change the state of the register. Whatever the register will do in synchronous with the clock pulse. Then mainly it has to perform two activities. One is loading, another is unloading or shifting in and shifting out. So what is the meaning of shifting in and shifting out? Suppose you have a memory or register and you want to store a data, store a word. Then the process of shifting in the data from outside to inside the register is known as the shifting in or loading. But the process of taking out the data from the register to the outside. Suppose already you have a register and within the register you have some data stored within that, and you try to retrieve that data to the outside. Then that process is known as shifting out or unloading. These two activity each and every memory device and each and every, most of the, some special cases also available, but in most of the register we have to perform these two activities. The next is So now we can use for understanding of the definition. Suppose you have a 4-bit register like this. You have a 4-bit register. So it can, for example, we consider a 4-bit register, whatever may be the type of register. Now classification is not. So you want to store 1011, a 4-bit word within the register. Then you have to the process of shifting this word into the register is known as loading. But the process of taking out that data from the register to the outside is known as shifting out or unloading. Then next, where we get the registers? Basically, you say shift register, or simply we can call the register. Shift register also named as the registers. And basically the registers are available in these places. These are the important places where we get the registers. For example, within the calculators or computers, or within the memory device. Even if the memory device used inside this device, calculators or computers you get, then for data converter, for example, in case of ADC, ADC is used in transmitter side, and in that case for converting serial data to parallel data, we can take the registers. Similarly, in case of receiver side, we can use the register for converting the parallel data to serial data. So if you go through the DAC and ADC, you must get the presence of register in transmitter side and also in the receiver side. Then also you can use the register for sequence generator. 0 and 1 sequence we can generate by the register. Then in different counters also you can get the presence of register, like ring counter and junction counter. Then next we go through the why. What is the need of using the register or shift register? These are the basic or broadly the main important points why we are using the registers. So what are those? Basically, due to register, we can easily move the data from one place to another place. And if you go through in detail the microprocessor or any processor system, then only due to the memory, it is very flexible to store the data and to retrieve the data. So requirement, the data movement is very much helpful. Then also data conversion we can do, where we need the conversion from serial to parallel, or where we need the conversion from parallel to serial, that can be possible by the registers. After completion of the types, you can easily understand this point. Then it is also used for data storage, which is the prime duty of register or shift register. Mainly register means data storage. Then next, for better communication, automatically if we can able to store and retrieve something, so automatically that will be helpful in networking or communications. The next, we consider these are the different types of registers. So basically the shift register or registers are classified into 4 classes. One is known as serial in serial out shift register or SIPO. Another is known as first as 4 categories. One is known as serial in serial out shift register. Second one is known as serial in parallel out register. Third one is known as parallel in serial out register. And the fourth one is known as the parallel in parallel out register. So how you take the name, that depends upon you. There is no constant rule to maintain the series, but the designation should be perfect. Then first of all, we have to know the basic meaning and basic difference among these 4 shift registers or registers. So how we can easily remember the difference? Now let us start the discussion. This is what is the meaning over the SISO, serial in serial out. As per its name, you can write something about this. Serial in serial out means we can load the data serially one bit after another, and also we can unload the data serially one bit after another. For example, if you have, now see, suppose we have a 4-bit word, same 4-bit word, any 4-bit word you can take 1101. 4-bit is the very basic fundamental register. This is a 4-bit word. We start loading in SIPO starting from LSB. First 1 will be loaded, then 0 will be loaded, then 1 will be loaded, then last MSB 1 will be loaded. But it has no capability. Maintains the shifting of data serially, one bit after another, and most important is shifting starts from LSB, not from MSB. Another point, when this shifting in is going on, for each bit shifting one clock pulse is required. So accordingly, for 4-bit shifting, 4 clock pulses are required. So register, SISO register means serially we have to shift or load. Similarly, shifting out, in this case, when after loading this 4-bit data, if your purpose is to unload this 4-bit data, then you have to unload starting from LSB, first one, then second, then third, then fourth. During the unloading process also, you have to shift out the bits serially, one bit after another. Similarly, for each bit shifting out, one clock pulse is required. So for 4-bit shifting out, 4 clock pulses are required. So overall, total number of clock pulses required in case of a 4-bit SISO is 4 plus 4 equal to 8. 4 plus shifting in and 4 plus shifting out. Accordingly, if you take higher order, you can measure. 5-bit means 5 pulse for shifting, 5 pulse for shifting out or unloading. Then this type of register symbolically we can show like this. Basically the registers are consisting of flip-flops. For 1-bit, one flip-flop is required. And most commonly you are using in this session the D flip-flops. Later on I will show you. So this is the basic symbol or block diagram of a SISO register. Now see. SISO means serial in, serial out, so it must have a single input and a single output. Because you have to do everything loading and unloading bit by bit, the number of input and number of output is not available here. A single input and a single output. Using this single input, you have to load one bit after another. So, then for controlling this, one clock source is used. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, these are the 4 flip-flops. Each flip-flop is storing 1 bit. That means shifting in these 4 bits, the MSB 1 will be in register A, the next bit will be in register B, the next bit will be in C, and our LSB will be in last stage D. Automatically wo shifting in karke serially load ho jayega. Similarly, jab unload karoge, to while you are unloading the data, then 1 bit after another, that will be unloaded. Then next we go through the SIPO. As per its name also you can write, SIPO means serial in parallel out. That means we have to load serially one bit after another starting from LSB. But while we are unloading, at a time we can unload all the bits. So accordingly, it has single input but parallel outputs. Suppose you consider the example of a 4-bit SIPO, then it has a single input, and by using this single input, the 4-bit data will be loaded one by one after another. After loading, when you try to unload by using a single clock pulse, you can unload all the bits, and all the bits will be available over the output lines parallelly. So in this case, total number of clock pulse requirement is 4 clock pulse required for 4 clock pulse required for serial in, if you consider the 4-bit register. 4 clock pulses for shifting in or loading, and a single clock pulse for unloading. So total 5 clock pulses are required for entire operation. The next one is PISO. Also we can guess something from its name. Parallel in, serial out. Parallel means simultaneously we have to do. So in is parallel here. That means all the data bits will be loaded parallelly or at a time by using a single clock pulse. So accordingly, the symbol C, it has number of or multiple number of inputs, and the number of inputs depends on the how much bit of register you are considering. Suppose you consider 4-bit register, then accordingly it has 4 input lines. But serial out, so accordingly only 1 output lines. Serial word, always you have to use a single, whether it is output side or input side. So in this case, serial word is in output side, so accordingly we have a 1 output line in output side. So at a time we can load all the data bits by using a single clock pulse, but while we are unloading the contents from the register to the outside, we have to suppose 4 bits are available 1100 here. So you start unloading through this output line, first 0, then next bit, then next bit, then next bit. 4 clock pulses will be required. Then your last one is parallel in, parallel out. As per its name, we have to load or shifting in the data parallelly at a time by using a single clock pulse, and also we can unload the data or contents at a time by using a single clock pulse. For example, suppose this is a 4-bit PIPO. This is a 4-bit PIPO having 4 flip-flops, 1, 2, 3, 4. And already, initially, this register is vacant. And you try to load 1, 0. You try to load 1, 0, 1, 1, for example. So, apply a single clock pulse. And all the 4 bits you can apply through these 4 input lines. Then by application of a single clock pulse, all will be shifted into the corresponding flip-flops or into the registers. Actually, each bit will be transferred to the output side of the one flip-flop. The 4 flip-flop means 4 bits will be shifted in. Then it has 4 output lines. When you apply a single clock pulse, all the 4 stored bits will be available over the output lines. The one clock pulse here is required for a loading purpose. Another clock pulse is required here for the unloading purpose. So now tell me, or you can imagine also yourself, which one is the highest speed register? In CISO, you have 4 plus 4, 8 clock pulse. In SIPO, you have 4 plus 1 clock pulse. In CISO, you have 1 plus 4. And in PIPO, you have 1 plus 1. So, this one is the highest speed register. But all the registers have the application in practical life as for the requirement. And we all discuss in a special class, which was available in outline as the application. That part I will take a special class. Which one is helpful in which area and why? That is a special class. Now, these are the all over about the meaning of 4 flip-flops, 4 registers. Then next, we can start in detail how a CISO works. That is the definition of 4 registers. But now we can implement the 4 registers, and out of 4 registers, today, let us finish the CISO. Suppose we consider the 4-bit CISO, 8-bit CISO, 16-bit CISO also possible. But for a standard, we here consider the 4-bit CISO. So, meaning already with us, one input line and one output line, because serial we have to load and serial we have to unload. So, 4-bit CISO means actually the number of bit indicates the number of flip-flops required for that register. Here the register is 4 bit means you have to use the 4 flip-flops, and accordingly in this case you have 4 flip-flops, and basically we are considering here the D flip-flops. So 4 flip-flops, as for the naming you can put, and this is for the LSB, this is for the next higher bit, this is for the next, and this one is for the MSB. So how we load now? So it has one input, one output, and one clock pulse, clock source is applied simultaneously to all flip-flops. Now see, this is the way of applying the clock pulse to all flip-flops. your all flip-flops may be negative triggered or positive triggered, but as per this diagram, we are triggering our flip-flops in negative. This bubble cap means, already I have told you how you identify whether your flip-flop is positive triggered or an S triggered or a negative S triggered. So from this diagram, we can directly consider or directly decide this all the flip-flops are negative triggered. Then you start one example we take. Initially, before starting loading, first of all, you have to reset the flip-flops. Sorry, all the flip-flops would be in initial state or a reset condition. Or overall, you can take the resistor will be under the reset condition. Reset condition means here you have 0, here also initially you have 0, here also 0, here also 0. All the flip-flops are 0. So before starting loading, please recall the D flip-flop. What is the basic function of D flip-flop? It has one input and two main output is the Q and this is the complemented output. What is the role? And this is your clock source. When you apply 0 here, that will be transferred to here. When you apply 1 here, that will be 1. Your output will be 1. This is the basic function of your D flip-flop. The same function used here. So initially all the flip-flops are under the reset condition. Or your register contents are under the 0 state. Then we start loading. Suppose your purpose is to load 1011. So how you load serially? When you apply the first clock pulse here, this LSB, when you apply the input, first bit will be available here at the input of first flip-flop. Then apply a clock pulse. When you apply a clock pulse, due to this 1, your output will be 1 here. Because D equal to 1 means Q also 1. Then, during the same time, this flip-flop is getting the input, this one. And due to this 0, you are getting 0 here. Then this flip-flop input is 0. And due to 0, you are getting again 0. Similarly, this flip-flop is getting input 0. And due to this, you are getting 0. Now, clock pulse, your contents are 1000. Till time, loading not finished. Then, second, after due to this one, next bit will reach here. Then this bit will reach here. And due to this, when you apply the second clock pulse, again, your input here will be 1. Sorry, due to this input 1, your output will be 1. But during the same time, this 1 will be the input for the second flip-flop. And that will create 1 here. To this, your input is 0. And due to this 0, you are getting again 0. The input to this is 0. And due to this 0, you are getting again 0. And now your contents are 1100. Similarly, when you, after completion of this bit, then third bit will be here. Third bit will be here. And when you apply the clock pulse, all the flip-flops will change the state as per their input condition. And finally, after completion of the fourth clock pulse, if you study or check the contents of your register, you must get 1 here, 0 here, 1 here and 1 here. That means loading now finished. So whatever loading here happens, not at a time, serially. Serially that will be shifted towards and one bit again acting as the input, not at a time. Similarly, when you shifting out, already the contents is 1011, already your contents 1011 loaded condition. Then you start unloading. Same process will happen. Now you don't have any input and you, when you start unloading, after first clock pulse, this one will be out and this one will be shifted here. This 0 will be shifted here, this 1 will be shifted here. And no input here, accordingly 0 will be shifted here. Then after second clock pulse, this one already gone, then this one here. The contents 1 by 1 will be shifted towards the right. And finally after 4 clock pulse, all the outputs will be under 0 state. All the flip-flop outputs will be under the 0 state. That means your unloading completely finished. So this type of register actually takes a long time to perform the shifting in and out. So this is the slowest register. The next register is the SIPO. Similarly, we can consider the 4-bit SIPO. The 4-bit SIPO, also 4-bit means 4 flip-flops. Here also we can take the D flip-flops. But what is the difference from before? In this case, you are applying the input serially. Accordingly, it has one serial data input. But you have to collect the output parallelly. Accordingly, you have 4 output lines. In before diagram, you have one output line. The same diagram also you can modify. Please see, if you modify this diagram, you can convert this diagram, this logic circuit to PISO. How? Suppose this is a serial in, serial out. We try to convert it to SIPO, serial in, parallel out. So keep it as usual. Only take 4 output lines from output of each D flip-flop. Now compare, you can see 4 output lines are taken from output of each flip-flops. Clock is as usual in before diagram, but here one extra change I have introduced because of knowing the meaning of clear. Actually, in before diagram I have told, before starting the loading and unloading, first of all we have to reset the all flip-flops or reset the registers, and that activity is performed by this controlling signal known as the clear. The clear controlling signal you can use in all type of sequential circuits like flip-flop and also in register and also in counter. And the purpose of this control signal is, whatever may be the present state of your device, that will clear or returns your device to the initial state or 00 state. So that for all circuits, you can introduce in all circuits or you can ignore in each circuit, but whether you are ignoring, always that controlling signal is present. And in practical case, we all have to use that signal to clear or reset the circuit or to return our circuit to the initial state. Now, when we start loading here, the 4-bit, the 4-bit loading process is same as the before, one bit after another. But when we try to unload the data will be unloaded at a time by applying a, when you apply a single clock pulse here, all the contents available at the output of each flip-flop, that will be appear here. Nobody will wait to before or next flip-flops. All will be available. Then this one is your for your next class. And this one is also for your next class. We will discuss in detail about PISO and PIPO. This is for your next class. Thank you to all. Please collect any doubt and ask for further interaction in next class. And also I will give you some questions to you. Try to solve and then clear your doubts.